thyroid gland is a gland at the base of the neck that controls our metabolism or how much fuel we burn. There are essentially three reasons why the thyroid glands may require removal. Firstly, the glands may become overactive. Secondly, nodules or lumps can begin growing within the thyroid gland, which produces a condition called goiter, which can lead to cosmetic or even compressive concerns for the patient. And finally, some of the lumps within the thyroid gland can be cancerous. The parathyroid glands are glands in the base of the neck that control calcium metabolism. Occasionally, one or more of these glands can become overactive, which leads to calcium being taken out of the bones and results in a high calcium level. So these patients will be referred for surgery to remove the offending gland or glands to restore normal calcium levels. The thyroid gland produces a hormone called thyroxin, which is essential to life. Without thyroxin, all our bodily processes would tend to slow down. So it is very important for normal health that we receive thyroid hormone. Parathyroid glands are important for controlling calcium metabolism in the body. It's vital that we have parathyroid hormone function, because without that, our calcium would drop to levels where essentially the muscles would go into spasm. Thyroid surgery essentially involves either removing half or all of the thyroid gland. The length of the operation can be anything from 30 minutes to approximately 2 hours, depending on the complexity. The risks of thyroid surgery have to be carefully discussed with the patient, so that all patients have informed consent. Like all operations, there is a small risk of bleeding and infection, which is very low with thyroid surgery. Specific to the operation itself are, first of all, injury to the nerves, which are very closely approximated to the thyroid gland, particularly the nerves that control the voice. So it is possible for these nerves to be injured either temporarily or permanently, which might lead to hoarseness. The second very specific complication, and this really only applies when you've removed all the thyroid gland, is that the parathyroid glands that control calcium can also become either temporarily or permanently dysfunctional, which leads to a drop in the calcium level. Parathyroid surgery in most cases involves just removal of one gland, but on occasions, in fact not uncommonly, all four glands have to be inspected, identified, and then the abnormal ones removed. Parathyroid surgery can take anything between 20 minutes or 2 hours or more, depending on how difficult it is to find the abnormal glands or glands. The risks are very much generic, like all surgery, bleeding, infection. Again, the nerves to the voice box are very close to the parathyroid glands, so there's a very, very small risk that these nerves could be temporarily or permanently injured, but the risk is much less when compared to thyroid surgery. There is also a risk that the first operation may not cure the patient of the condition, as occasionally the parathyroid glands are in an abnormal situation anatomically, such as in the chest. Thyroid surgery essentially involves two approaches. The most common and conventional approach is to make an incision in the neck. Recently, pioneering techniques involving a robotically assisted surgery entails an incision made not in the neck, but in the armpit to avoid scarring. And this is particularly appropriate for patients who give a poor history of scarring, which we describe as keloid or even hypertrophic scarring. And that's very attractive to many patients, as the vast majority, in fact 80% of all thyroid surgery is performed in women. Parathyroid techniques essentially depend on preoperative localization. For single gland disease, then patients may be amenable to a minimally invasive technique, which involves a small 2 centimeter incision within the neck, which then enables the preoperatively identified parathyroid to be removed alone without disturbing the rest of the parathyroid glands. If preoperative localization does not identify the offending parathyroid, then a four gland approach is required. This involves a larger incision of approximately 4 centimeters so that all four parathyroid glands can be visualized and then the pathological glands removed. results of thyroid and parathyroid surgery are very much determined by the volume of thyroid and parathyroid surgery. There's very good evidence that the best results are produced by those surgeons that perform high volume thyroid and parathyroid surgery. The British Association of Thyroid and Endocrine Surgeons has a national database, and I would very much encourage all patients to look at the database, as this is now in the public domain. It's been mandated that all thyroid and parathyroid surgeons should enter their data into the registry. Other important routes of referral, of course, are via the general practitioner, and in particular the endocrinologist, which will be very aware of the surgeon's results, as a thyroid and parathyroid surgeon has to work very closely with the endocrinology specialty.